Hey guys, and welcome back for more Stardew Valley. Stir fry, I already know how to cook that. Alright. Oh, we got we get our kitty cat! All these events, man, taking up my recording time. Yes, I will adopt this cat. Puss it is. Cause he's orange like Puss in Boots. I'm sorry I didn't read all your dialogue, but I'm in a hurry. We got some parsnips that are grown here. That's cool. Next time we plant our next set of seeds, I will use fertilizer instead, so it will be able to get some higher yield crops, like the silver star and the gold star ones. But we're gonna go head over and let me grab my fishing pole. We're gonna do some fishing today. We are going to head over and loot the trash cans and drop this chicken statue over at the library. There's a dandelion we can eat later. The reason I keep looking around for this forage stuff, guys, is I need to level up that stat. And the only way to level it up is to just pick stuff up off the ground and stuff. So, yep, just going to keep looking around for those. I don't have a catfish. There's some green algae I can eat. There are two trash cans over here, and then we'll head over to the library. And another field snack. This is why you loot those garbage cans every day, at least at the beginning, until you can get a consistent source of food, guys. Where am I going? I need to go to the library first. There's two more trash cans to loot. I don't think they open until 9 or 10 anyway. Broken CD, not worth anything. You can make some stuff out of those broken items later, but for right now, oh, it is open, cool. For right now, they're just trash and they don't sell for anything, so. And another cutscene because we got a artifact. Abysmal, not a single piece in the entire collection. What's this? You found something. Let me see it. Chicken statue. Remarkable! It's very old. I'd love to study this in greater detail, but it's yours. I've got a favor to ask you. Would you consider donating any new artifacts or minerals that you find? We could make a groundbreaking discovery together. Oh, and who knows, if you keep donating, I might come across some interesting items to send your way. Think about it, will you? If you decide to donate, just bring objects to the front desk. The previous runner of the library slash museum stole all the stuff when he left. Chicken statue. $250 gold. Awesome. Alright, now we can go to the beach, and I'm going to show you guys how fishing works. Got close to full energy, not quite full, but... cast it out to max there. Boop, boop. Come on. And then you like click and try and keep the fish in there. Gets a lot easier once you have better poles. There's also lures you can buy in here to make fishing a lot easier. Which I might do. Trout soup. Gives you some plus one fishing and get a lot of energy, actually. I don't think I've actually ever talked to you. Come here. What's this? Okay. Back to fishing. So there's a... They might have patched it. I don't know... You used to be able to fish for as long as you wanted, by let's see if it still works. Does still work. You can when you're in your menus and stuff, time freezes. So if you, basically you can fish longer during the day. If you open up your little journal here, it freezes the time. And then when you hear it, you can just pull the, click the mouse and it'll take you right into this. So you can fish as long as you have energy. And you can just keep fishing. Until you run out of energy and food. It's pretty nice. You could also buy one of those fish soups in there to get better stuff while you're fishing and raise your energy a little bit. Good way to make money at the start of the game. You could also... I mean, I guess you could potentially use it for food too, but they only restore like 15 or 20, like these sardines, 18. Like, I'm not gonna waste my time. I'm just gonna sell them and get some money. Damn it. You also have to click this little icon up here. You can't just hit the F button. I wish I had fished a couple days ago. Somebody on the bulletin board wanted some seaweed and they would have gave me 60 gold for it. I'd like to get something other than a sardine, please. I was gonna go for that treasure. It's a lot easier when you have a better pole. I don't remember how you get the fishing pole upgrades. I'll have to look it up off camera. Because your bar gets wider and stuff. Maybe you can just craft them as you level up your fishing. Maybe that's how you get it. I don't remember. I know you can make bait and different lures and stuff to help it as well, so. Ooh, a herring. You can get a recipe off of the TV, or one of the people gives it to you, one of the two. You use seaweed and any type of fish. I'm gonna get the treasure this time. Oh, come on! You use seaweed and any type of fish, and you can make like sashimi rolls or something like that. Sushi rolls and stuff. Ooh, there's a big pool of them out there. I wonder if I can land in that. Boop, boop. Georgia Cola. You also make like lobster traps to stick up here on the shore, and it gives you like crawfish and lobster and crabs and stuff like that. But again, gotta level up your stuff so you can unlock those crafting recipes, so. Yeah, you can get good stuff out of the treasure chest from these too, like ores, and you can get like artifacts for the library and stuff like that, so definitely worth doing some fishing. Wasn't fast enough on that one. All right, I'm going for it. I got it. And I got a geode. Anchovies. I'm gonna go ahead and drink this Georgia Cola. And I'm gonna eat that. Toot toot. The little swirly is gone. I wonder if I can get my hook in those and get like special fish or something. I'm gonna be done with fishing for now. It's a good way to make money at the beginning of the game, like I said. There's a couple like big special fish you can catch too. It's for I mean, you can catch them for one of the cheap achievements, which I've already done, so probably not going to try and do those on this playthrough, because they're extremely frustrating, and they only sell for a couple thousand gold anyway, so... Ooh, there's little wormy guys down here. Rusty spoon, another artifact. So you always want to dig... Always want to dig those little wormy guys up, because they can have, like, a dinosaur egg, which is, like, basically a chicken, but their eggs are worth more, and they can have, like, clay, and... they can have an ancient fruit seed, which is how I make my money towards the end of the game. When you donate enough stuff to Gunther, he gives you like special items and stuff. So you always want to be looking out for those little guys on the ground. They're super worth it. I didn't figure that out until like year two in my game, and I really suffered because of it. So... You can get different kinds of fish when you fish in different areas too, like this river has different fish than the ocean, and then the mountain lake up there has the different fish, and there's a couple types of fish you can only catch at certain levels of the mines and stuff like that, so fishing's kind of unique in this game, I guess. I'm gonna hang on to the seaweed. Guess with what little time and energy we have left for today, I'm going to start cleaning out a couple of remaining trees that we got. Really, all we have is all these pine trees down here, which is good, actually really good. Eat this field snack. I think that's all we're gonna get today. I'm gonna see what these seeds are going into. I need to go and buy some seeds though. I'll get them tomorrow. Hello, kitty. Hey, level up fishing. 400 gold for like what? 5, maybe 10 minutes of fishing, so. Definitely worth it. Two things I already knew, thank you very much. Um, I believe her axe is down at the lake. Not the lake, like down there in the forest. Okay, just making sure I got that one. So we're gonna go grab that, because that's 250 gold that we could have, and then we're gonna go to Pierre's and buy some seeds. Oh, look at all these radishes. I want to say her axe is like down here by the sewer drain. There's all those spring onions, and here is her axe. I am correct. This is what I was telling you about. This should be a lot of fucking food right here. I guess it's not a lot of food all at once, but there's a bunch of them, so I'm not gonna complain. Plus it levels up my foraging, so. Okay, let's go give Robin her axe. And get our 250 gold. I may as well go this way through town and loot everybody's trash cans. I need to go to Pierre's too anyway, so I was gonna go through the mountain to see if I could find more forageables, but yeah. What's up, guys? And a field snack. I'm broken CD. Go check these last two trash cans over here and head to Pierre's and then head to Robin's up in the mountain. Didn't find any new wormy guys for you yet. All right, Pierre. I want a little bit of everything, so I'm gonna get 10 of these, and then one of these, one of these, one of these. Bean, cauliflower, kale, potato. I already shipped parsnips, so I'm gonna go with potatoes. So that's what, 13? So I need just go with 10 more. Okay, let's go give Robin her axe back. I also need to get those on the ground ASAP because not sure how much more time we have in this season, but they're only good for this season, so. This episode is going to run probably just a little bit long. Robin, I brought you your axe. They're little wormy guys. Some copper ore. I will take that. Ooh, more little wormy guys. And some coal. I will also take that. There's a leak. Okay, let's get some plants in the ground. To all my bean plants up top, because I don't believe you can walk through those. So I'm gonna make my fence bigger as well. And there's another treasure for the museum. Some wood. Gonna fill the back here with the beans, and then I'm gonna put the potatoes in front of that. Some kale, some cauliflower. There's all the seeds I bought. Yeah, you can't walk through those, so. And now, basically, I'm not gonna be able to do anything else but take care of these crops for the next couple days. Okay, cool. I'm gonna put this wood back up and this fence, because this fence is got all this food. I'm gonna run back to the library real quick and donate this rusty spur. There's a leak over here I can pick up too. Oh, and little wormy guys, cool. Maybe I'll get another artifact. And I did. Prehistoric vertebra. Getting all kinds of artifacts. Maybe I'll get a reward from the museum. I hope it doesn't close before I get there. That would suck. Still nothing, really? Okay. I'm gonna head home and see what level ups we get, and then I'm gonna end the episode. That was a cute little bunny rabbit running in the bush over there. Go in there, Clay. It's already running long. We can use what little energy we have left to clear out some trees. I got all this food, so. I was like, I know you can hit it from the front. Still falls on the side, but. Oh, there's some little wormy guys right there. Aww, I'm so dumb. I didn't put fertilizer on all those crops I planted. All it takes is 2 sap to improve the quality of your crops too. Man! It's okay. I'll do it next time. I'll just get some parsnips or something next time. Sad face. Go ahead and go to sleep and see what level ups we get, you guys. Level 4, foraging. I can make a charcoal kiln and wild seed summer. So that's cool. 30 gold. Alright, and that's where I'm gonna end it off. I'm gonna do some fishing off camera and do some more cleaning up of the farm. Take care of those crops, and I will see you guys in the next episode.